In last part, Chu Xia was dreaming. When Chu Xia woke up, the rain had just stopped. The moonlight poked out from behind the clouds, spilling its gentle glow onto the bedroom of Mihi's resident. It felt as though it was in the peak of autumn. As the dew drops fell on the sycamore leaves with crisp echoes, the palace was empty and deserted, and it was as though the entire world had died, with only her left. Slowly moving her body, the dry and cold wind pierced her body, reminding that she was still alive. From the Rofu Palace, there were loud sounds of musical instruments playing. That was the nightly party that Xiao Jie held. Every night at this time, there will be some form of celebration that decorates this grandiose palace. When Chu Xiao was first rescued, the court had a strong wave of opposition. The hundreds of officials endlessly expressed their disdain for Emperor Xiao Jie's actions. After debating with them for over 10 days, Xiao Jie finally flipped and, kicking down the thorn, he blew that he did not want to be the emperor anymore, and that whoever wanted to could take the throne from him. The official lost their composure. Only after kneeling outside the Changxing Palace for 2 whole days did they manage to convince this emperor, who had skipped over 70 days of work in merely 2 years after being thorned. Since then, no one dared to mention Chu Xiao again. On the other hand, Xiao Jie's behavior was comforting to the officials. Apart from how he had paid particular attention to Chu Xiao in the first few days, he had mostly returned to the playboy he was. With him returning to normal, the officials finally heaved a sign of relief. Deep down, many thought that this Yanbei woman must not have that much attractiveness anyway. The very fact that Xiao Jie even went ahead to save her was probably on a whim anyway. When Xiao Jie entered, Chu Xiao had not made any noise, so he thought that she was still sleeping. Carefully tiptoeing, he acted like a burglar, resulting in the amusement of the maid servants, who were watching. Covering their mouths, they did not dare to laugh out loud. After lifting up the veil and seeing Chu Xiao, who was sitting on the bed, Xiao Jie was slightly taken aback as he smiled and walked over. Holding a basket, he acted as though he was presenting some kind of treasure. As he said, "Someone brought fresh pomegranates. Do you want to eat?" Chu Xiao did not reply. She still seemed drowsy, as though she had not fully woke up. Xiao Jie sat beside her and looked at her still pale and skinny face. At that time, Chu Xiao said that, "Xiao Jie, I have fully recovered. I want to leave." Her voice was exceedingly calm. Looking at her, Xiao Jie would often get the misconception that it was 3 years ago when she lived in his palace, and nothing had changed. Yet he started to realize that things were already different. She would no longer confidently tell him about her dreams and ambitions, and would no longer talk about that man with a sparkle in her eyes, and had hopes and wishes for the future. Even her pair of eyes lost the shine she used to have, as though her crystal clear iris has been covered by a blanket of mist. Xiao Jie asked her where will she go, and she replied that she don't know. Xiao Jie did not speak, but merely looked at her. The playfulness in his eyes faded away and had turned to serenity and peace. After a long hesitation, he started to ask her, "For the Jin family, you become enemy of the Yuan family. For repaying your gratitude to Yan Shun, you followed him for 8 years in Shengjin Palace, living as a slave. For the Yanbei civilians, you went through life and death countless times. For the Southwest emissaries garrison, you got angry with Yan Shun. For Yuan Yu, you hide from worldly matters for 2 years. For the Da Tong Guild, you completely fell out with Yan Shun. Now, for not dragging me into the fray, you are going to head beyond the borders into the barren lands." The man's voice turned deep with a tinge of fatigue that he could not seem to hide anymore. Quietly he asked, "Xiao Xiao, in your life, will you ever start to do things for yourself?" Zhu Xiao was utterly stunned by that question, with the night wind blowing past, lifting up her clothes. Xiao Jie lightly held onto her shoulder, and with his other hand gently clasped her head, and whispered, "Xiao Xiao, there are many ways to live in the world. You can live your life in poverty, but that is still one life. You can live your life enjoying all of the worldly pleasures, and that is still one life. You can live your life aimlessly without doing much, yet that is still one life. You can also live your life accomplishing great things that will leave your name in history forever, and even then, that is still one life. But despite so many ways, why do you forever choose the way that makes life the hardest for you? Look at you. Even the normal civilians probably lead a better life than you." Xiao Jie's voice slowly entered her ears and crept into her mind. Zhu Xiao leaned on his chest, and even her entire thought process frozen up. She suddenly felt that his words were so true. If she really led a simple life like a normal civilian, she would certainly not have gone through so many ups and downs, without so many killings and sadness, without betrayals and backstabbing, lying and abandonment. And she would definitely not be so heartbroken, with no place to go. As the days passed, winter began. That said, in the Tang Empire, even in winter it would not feel chilly. As Zhu Xiao ultimately still stayed in the Jin Wu Palace, although she had no rank nor appointment, women like her were commonplace in this palace. Coupled with her previous reputation, no one dared to find any troubles with her. There spread that some grand marshal from the Xia Empire would like to establish a friendly relationship with the Liang Empire, and as a result, the Xia Empire had not come to seek trouble with Lady, but it was not certain. Thank you for staying right beside me. Feel free to share, comment, and subscribe. Don't forget to like the videos to know the further story of the Princess Agents Season 2. There are many more in upcoming part. We will see the encounter of Zhu Xiao and Yu Wen Yu. Thank you.